Happy day 7 of Inktober! Can you believe it? We're already an entire week into Inktober. About a quarter of the way is done, I guess. The prompt for day 7 was Enchanted. So my way of thinking was just, there aren't that many creatures much more magical and enchanted than a unicorn, right? Horses are one of my all-time favorite creatures. So it makes total sense that I would get to them sooner or later in Inktober. I thought I would add that kind of diamond geometric shaped background just to give the drawing a bit more depth, I suppose. And I guess it kind of fits with the enchanted theme as well, since it's kind of like, you know, a diamond shape, enchanted. And for this piece, I wanted to do a really good job with the shading and having kind of two different light sources. So I used my warmer toned Copic marker to get more of a light warm color on the right side of the unicorn, and then I used a cooler toned one on the left side, and you can kind of see how it splits down the middle like that. And that was just in order to get kind of a cool lighting effect. And then once I had those warm and cool regions established, I went back and started darkening up all the shadows. For this one, I had to be careful not to go too dark. Sometimes it can be easy to just keep putting darker and darker colors in the same spots, just because it's easy since you've already established the shadow areas. But if you do that too much, then you kind of lose the drawing. It starts looking less realistic simply because not all shadows are gonna be the same level of darkness. And then I went in and added a little bit of blue to the cool side just to make it pop more. Then I just went back in and added a very darker gray and a little bit of black just to the darkest areas of shadow so that I wouldn't overwhelm the rest of the drawing. And then I thought I would do a similar tone style to what I already had in the drawing. So I did a warmer toned purple on the right side of the drawing, and then I went back and did a cooler purple on the left side. And once all that was done, I went back in with my metallic silver ink pen and started adding all the fun shiny sparkles that should obviously be on a unicorn, am I right? And then I also did the geometric border. And I didn't want to just go around the diamond because I thought that'd be kind of boring and expected. So I kind of did it as if there was another diamond overlapping the one I had already done, just to give it a bit more movement, I suppose. And I didn't want the lines to be too neat and tidy, just because I thought that would be more interesting. Thank you so much for watching. Please leave a comment down below about what you thought of the first week of Inktober. If you're doing the challenge too, tell me how it went. If you managed to stick it out and get one done for each day. I will see you tomorrow for day 8 and the second week of Inktober.